They have lost the vision. Imagine how important this eye is for a human being. It is the only complete layer of the eye. So it is not discontinuous. It is the complete layer of the eye. Choroid, which is the second layer of the eye, which is also called as tunica vascularis. And the diameter of the pupil is regulated by the muscle of the iris. Hello everyone. Welcome back to session 7 of this chapter 21 of your syllabus called Neural Control and Coordination. Myself, Bisho Barani, from the Department of Biology, Vidyashram, Pre-University College, the Temple of Excellence. So, in the last session, we studied about the receptor, the sensory neuron. Let us study about the motor neuron. So, what is a motor neuron? So, already we have studied the region of central nervous system initiates response for the stimuli. Here you can see, as we already studied the structure of a neuron, which is the structural and functional unit of nervous system, which comprises of the cell body, the axon and the dendrite. So, here you can see in beautiful picture about the motor neuron. So, here dendrites are going to collect the signals and the signals passes through the axon. From the axon, this is a myelinated neuron where it is covered over by a myelin sheath. Then it goes to the neuromuscular junction, that is the synaptic knobs. Hope you remember that the synaptic knobs contain neurotransmitters, and having neurotransmitter chemicals, like it might be acid, that is dopamine, or it might be acetylcholine. So from there on, it goes to the muscle fiber, which is the effector. From the receptor, that is the skin might be a receptor. So the region of central nervous system initiates response for the stimuli. So what is a motor neuron? It transmits response from CNS to the effector. Sensory neuron, from the response, that is skin. Skin is a receptor. From the receptor to the CNS, right? So it, motor neuron, hence the name, it is called sensory neuron. Motor neuron, it transmits response from CNS to the effector. So what is an effector? It might be a muscle or a gland that receive motor impulses and exhibit responses. So sensory neuron, so is carried on to the receptor. So receptor might be a skin. So here, whereas motor neuron, it transmits response from CNS to the effector. So effector, it might be a muscle or a gland that receive motor impulses and exhibit response. So here you can see the muscle. Muscle is an effector. Skin is a receptor. So collect signals. Dendrites collect signals from the skin. Skin is a receptor. From there on, the dendrites pass on the signals to axon. From the axons to the telodendria, which is having synaptic knobs, which is also called as neuromuscular junction, which has neurotransmitters like dopamine or acetylcholine, and they pass on the signal or impulse to the effector. Here the effector might be a muscle fiber. So the region of central nervous system initiates response for the stimuli. Motor neurons, it transmits response from CNS to the effector. Effector, it may be a muscle or a gland that receive motor impulses and exhibit response. Moving on to the, I hope if you see this beautiful picture, then you can make a guess as, yes, in this particular session, we are also going to discuss about a very important sensory processing structure called the eye. So this is the structure of a human eye. I think all of us know how important eye is for us. Eye is an organ of vision. We see this beautiful world with this beautiful eye. So eye is a very, very important sensory processing structure, we can say. And it is very important for what? Eye is an organ of, it is an organ of vision. Imagine There are many a people, blind people, where they don't have the eyes to see this beautiful world. They have lost the vision. Imagine how important this eye is for a human being. Now, let us study about the structure of an eye and how it is able to process the image. So, we are seeing everything around us with this eye. All of us know the different parts of the eye, but as I keep telling that this chapter, particularly neuromuscular, that is neural control and coordination, is a very, very important chapter, we can say, because the concepts what we learn is very important for the other physiological processes. Now, let us understand the structure of our eye. So, what is the sensory reception and processing? So, one such organ is eye. So, here you can see the beautiful picture of an eye. So, let us describe the structure of the eye one by one. Eye is the sensory organ of vision. Everybody knows that it is a very important organ for vision. Vision means we are able to see the image, picture. Then, all of us know we have paired eyes, two eyes, one right and left eye, and are located in sockets of the skull called orbit. So, it is called eye orbit. So, eye is located in the eye orbit on either side of the body. Eye consists of three layers, very important three layers. One is called sclera. So, eye consists of three parts, you can say three very important layers. One is called the sclera, second one is called choroid, and the third one is called the retina. So, what are the three very important layers of eye? Eye consists of sclera, which is also called as tunica fibrosa. So, sclera, the chloracoroid, and retina. The white part of the eye. I know eyes are one form of expressions also. Eye expresses our feelings, our emotions, and thoughts. So, eye is not only an organ of vision, but also an organ of expressing our feelings, our emotions, and our thoughts. So, hence we call it as a very, very important sensory organ of our body, including it's a very important sensory organ of vision. So, our paired eyes, we have two eyes, paired eyes, which is located in the socket of the skull, where we call it as eye orbit. And eye consists of three very important layers. So, all of us know the white part of the eye is called the sclera. So, it is a continuous membrane, we can call it as. Now, and the second one is called choroid, and the third one is called the retina. So, here you can see the retina, then the choroid, and the white part of the eye, what we call it as sclera. Here you can see the sclera. Sclera, choroid, then the third part called the retina. So, these are the three layers of the eye. Three layers of eye. So, right. Now, sclera, which is also called as tunica fibrosa. This is the external layer. Here you can see the external layer. Sclera is the external layer. Retina is the internal layer. So, external layer composed of dense connective tissue. So, here sclera, which is the first outermost layer or the external layer, is composed of dense connective tissue. Then, it is the only complete layer of the eye. So, it is not discontinuous. It is the complete layer of the eye. Here you can see the sclera is the complete layer of the eye, and the anterior portion of this layer is transparent and is called cornea. So, the anterior part of sclera, here you can see, this is called cornea. So, the anterior, so cornea is the anterior portion. Cornea is the anterior portion of this layer, and it is transparent. So, cornea is transparent. Anterior portion of sclera, and it is transparent. and it is trans. Sometimes we can see somebody, the image of others in the eye, or in our eye itself, right? So it is a transparent. So, and called what? Cornea. So sensory reception and processing. We are moving on to the next very important concept called the sensory reception and processing, where eye is one such sensory organ which is responsible for processing the image or the vision. So eye is the sensory organ of vision, and we have paired eyes located on two either side of the skull, and it is located in a orbit in the skull called eye orbit. And eye consists of three layers. What are the three layers? Sclera, which is the which is also called as tunica fibrosa, then the choroid and the retina. So sclera is the external layer composed of dense connective tissue, and it is the only complete layer of the eye, which is not discontinuous. It is the complete layer of the eye, and the anterior portion of this layer called sclera is transparent, and it is called as what? Cornea. Here you can see the fovea, blind spot, optic nerve. Here you can see the vitreous humor, then you can see the iris, then the lens and the aqueous humor. All these are the parts of the eye. So moving on to the parts of the eye, what are the different parts of the eye? Sclera, choroid, retina. These are the three very important layers of the eye. Then there is a blind spot. Here you can see the blind spot, which will not have the photopigments. Then you can see the ciliary body, cornea, iris, then the lens, then the aqueous humor and the vitreous humor, and fovea and optic nerve. All these are the different parts of the eye. Moving on to the remaining concepts of this particular sensory organ called eye. So it is moving on to the next layer called choroid. Sclera is called as tunica fibrosa, whereas choroid is called tunica vascularis. Vascularis means what? Blood supply. So choroid, here you can see the choroid. Sclera, tunica fibrosa. Then choroid, tunica vascularis. So here you can see the sclera, choroid, retina, optic nerve, blind spot, fovea, iris, ciliary body, cornea, lens, then aqueous humor and vitreous humor. So choroid, choroid is the middle layer. Here you can see this is the choroid is the middle layer, whereas sclera is the external layer. Sclera is external, whereas choroid is middle layer. So it is the middle layer of the eye, and it is well vascularized and looks bluish color. Vascularized means what? Blood supply. And it looks bluish in color. Posterior two-third part is thin. So posterior two-third part is thin. Anterior part is thick and forms ciliary body. Here you can see the posterior part. That is a ciliary body, that is the posterior part is thin. That is here, this is thin and this is the thick region. This is the anterior. This is the anterior part. This is the posterior part. Posterior part is thin. So choroid, which is the second layer of the eye, which is also called as tunica vascularis. It is the middle layer of the eye. Here you can see it is the middle layer of the eye, and it is well vascularized and looks bluish in color. Posterior two-third part is thin. Here posterior two-third part is thin, whereas the anterior part is thick and form what? Ciliary body. Moving on to the third layer, that is the retina. So that is the ciliary body. Now let us understand what is ciliary body. The ciliary body itself contains forward to form a pigmented and opaque structure called iris. Here you can see the iris. So this is an opaque structure. Cornea is transparent, whereas iris is opaque. Right? Now the ciliary body itself contains forward to form a pigmented and opaque structure called iris, the visible colored portion of the eye. So the ciliary body itself contains forward to form a pigmented and opaque structure called iris, that is the visible colored portion of the eye. Iris contains a central aperture called pupil. So iris contains a central aperture called what? Pupil. We use a word called pupil of the eye. Pupil of the eye. Right. And the diameter of the pupil is regulated by the muscle of iris. Diameter means like we expand, we open up, we keep our eyes wide open, we constrict our eyes. Right. So the ciliary body itself contains forward to form a pigmented and opaque structure called iris. What is iris? The visible colored portion of the eye is called the iris. And iris contains a central aperture called pupil. And the diameter of the pupil is regulated by the muscle of the iris. For example, when we come across bright light, we close eyes. We constrict, we expand our eyes. So all that is made possible. Moving on to retina, the third layer of the eye, which is also called tunica nervosa. So tunica retina, which is also called as tunica nervosa. So here you can see the cornea, the eye. Here you can see the pupil, lens, and the retina, blood vessels, fovea and macula. See the blood vessels here. You can see the blood vessels. Even in the eye, we can see if eyes become red, we can see the blood vessels, right? So retina or tunica, that is, what was the first? The three layers we have come across. Sclera, which is the external layer. And choroid, the middle layer. And third one is retina, which is the innermost layer. So retina, which is also called as what? Tunica nervosa. It is the innermost layer of the eye. It consists of three layers of cells from inside to outside. So it contains three layers of cells. From inside to outside. It contains three layers. What are they? Ganglion cells, bipolar cells, and photoreceptor cells. So retina, which is the third layer of the eye, which is the innermost layer of the eye, consists of three layers of cells from inside to outside, namely ganglion cells, bipolar cells, and photoreceptor cells. Then there are two types of photoreceptor cells, are of two types. So photoreceptor cells. What are the three very important parts? Ganglion cells, bipolar cells, and photoreceptor cells. So photoreceptor cells, that is the photo, there are two types of photoreceptor cells. Namely, they're called as rods and cones. So two types of photoreceptors are the rods and the cones. They're called as photoreceptor cells, namely the rods and cones. Cones contain photopigment called iodopsin. So cones contain what? Iodopsin. Then cones are responsible for daylight. So it is called phototopic vision and color vision. So cones are responsible for daylight vision. Daylight vision means daytime, the vision what we see, daylight vision, and also color vision. We are able to distinguish the colors. You know, like you might have come across color blindness, right? Where the person will not be able to discriminate the red and the green color. Red and green color looks gray color for them, right? So as you know, we are able to visualize the colors, the pigment, the colors. And the color vision also is made possible by this very important photoreceptor cell called the cones. So photoreceptor cells are of two types. One is called rods, the other one is called cones. Cone contain a photopigment called iodopsin, which is responsible for daylight vision and also for color vision. Rods contain a photopigment called rhodopsin. They contain a photopigment called rhodopsin, or which is otherwise called visual purple, which contain a derivative of vitamin A. I think all of us know, like, we should have more of vitamin A for the eye, for the maintenance of the good vision of the eye, particularly like carrot. So like we are advised to have more of carrot because carrot has vitamin A, and as we all know that for proper vision of the eye, vitamin A is very important. Then contain a derivative of vitamin A. Rods are responsible for twilight, scototropic vision. Twilight means dim light. Here phototropic means for daylight vision. Daylight vision is called phototropic. Twilight vision is called scotopic, right? So we have come across ganglion cells. What are retina made up of? Ganglion cells, photobipolar cells and photoreceptor cells. So there are two types of photoreceptor cells. What are they? Rods and cones. Cones contain a photopigment called iodopsin, which is responsible for daylight vision and color vision. And whereas rods contain photopigment called rhodopsin, and or it is also called visual purple, which contain a derivative of vitamin A. Rods are responsible for twilight, or what we call it as scototropic vision. Hope you have understood the structure of the eye and the three very important layers of the eye, namely the sclera, then the choroid and the retina. See how important eye is for a human body. All the parts of the body are very important, and one such important organ of the body is the eye. As we know that we are seeing the beautiful world, we are able to have a vision, and that is all made possible by this wonderful organ called eye. So we need to protect our eye. I think all of us know how difficult it will be like if we do not have a proper vision. So this is a very important concept to be learned. Hope you have understood the structure of the eye. And in the coming session, I'll be dealing with the remaining concepts of this wonderful chapter called Neural Control and Coordination. Till then, goodbye and thank you.